on top of the world, but still with his feet firmly on the ground.
Hi, Amanda Davies.
Back at home in Serbia, Novak agreed to a rare interview with his wife, Jelena, to talk about their hopes for the next generation.
What was growing up here like for you guys?
From my perspective, I'm very fortunate to have a family who has invested in my education from the early on years, left the country at the age of 18 to study abroad and to continue my higher education. I've been part of the war and the economical and political crisis. It was an easy time.
Explosions sent fireballs into the sky and shattered windows in suburbs of Belgrade.
The consequences of the war are you know, felt many years after. In the Serbian history, the 10 years between 1991 and 2001 are probably one of the 10 most difficult years that we ever had as people. And we had two wars in the early 90s, and then we had bombings for 2.5 months in 1999. And in between, we had sanctions and embargo, and people waiting in the line for, you know, most basic things and needs and ingredients like bread and milk.
By day, Belgrade is now a shadow of its former self. Main streets are largely deserted. Fuel supplies are restricted to priority users, such as hospitals and public transport.
So I think the consequences of the war have forced many people to sacrifice and improvise. In my case, as a professional athlete, well, back in those days, I was still not professional, and I was dreaming, of course, to be the best tennis player in the world, and it sounded everything but realistic at that time, especially taking in consideration the circumstances I was growing up with. And so the family had to risk a lot, and they had to go out of their comfort zone and to make sure that I have all the conditions I need to become a tennis player. And so I think and these are only examples of our families, and there are many others that are
exactly
struggling a lot more.
And, actually, yeah, the statistics is that we have 180,000 children in Serbia, and every second child will get an opportunity to be part of the preschool education, which means that 90,000 children are not covered by the program.
The couple's now working to give back to Serbia through the Novak Djokovic Foundation. Novak's family started it in 2007, and now, nearly a decade on, its focus is on early childhood development.
We, as a foundation, have lots of work to do, and it's not something we're going to stop in the next few years. We're just now actually even building the endowment for the future, because right now it's Novak has the power and the voice to raise the awareness and raise the funds for investment in the preschool education programs. And in the future we might not have this power.
How has your attitude changed to this since you've become parents?
Shall I give you a I'm a mom, so I will be very passionate
loves
about
talking,
this.
So I'll let her talk. I'm enjoying here.
I'm taking over now.
You're doing a great job, darling.
No, I'm as a mom very passionate about this, and as somebody who has been alongside our team of the foundation, I'm breathing and feeling all the pain that a lot of families are feeling. And
we are seeing actually with our own eyes on an everyday basis with our son. You know, the importance of dedicating your time and creating a really stimulative environment and stimulating his brain growth in you know, different ways, and you can feel how receptive they are. It's incredible.
In May 2014, the Balkan floods saturated Serbia. The rising water endangered thousands of lives and damaged homes and schools. The city of Obrenovac was hit hardest by the floods, which took a toll on this kindergarten. Nearly 2 years after the disaster, I went to see the new school, rebuilt and refurbished by the Novak Djokovic Foundation.
It was a very difficult choice because there were so many people who were in need of help. And the fact that we were receiving so many requests, please help here, help there, help there. And we just didn't want to close our eyes and take a pic. You know, it wasn't something that was attractive to us. We wanted to make a proper step back and reflect on all the studies and research that has been done in the country in order to make the decision to invest a very strategic one and long-run one. So the decision to invest in the early childhood education is not a popular decision at all, because not many people see the benefits or the visible results in the short run.
Do sports stars do enough to help others?
There are many sports stars that are great examples of people that have this awareness and have the carry the responsibility in a great way. And they serve as a great example to many children around the world. There are many also athletes that maybe just don't realize, to what extent and to how far their voice goes to. So
with the social media
exactly,
now, you are constantly under pressure to.
You're
be,
under radar.
Yeah.
Everything that you do, that you say, is monitored, and
24 hours work. That's it.
Big brother. Some people may look at that as a burden, but I look at it as a great privilege and actually a great opportunity and platform to do something, and then create a change that, that will be positive.
Should we expect sports stars, athletes to be role models though?
Yes.
Absolutely.
I'm so, in a way, sad. Because my husband is, I feel like he's the greatest role model, but my son will never look at him that way. We need to find another athlete that will be a great role model for my son, because he will only be a daddy, right? And usually your children are influenced by other people. I really am looking forward to seeing more athletes maturing to that knowledge that this is, whatever I do, I'm a role model and I have to behave in the way that other children will inherit that model.
Through sport, I learned that really many things are possible. I think the athletes have the huge power to change the world, as Nelson Mandela said, and I think that power can be used in a very positive way.